Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So we're in the last 10 days of Ramadan, subhanAllah. And one of the closest things for us as children is a dua that we make for our parents. But for some of us, we don't have the energy or even the connection with our parents to even make the dua for them, for one reason or the other. And from the title of the topic today, or from the title of my discussion, you can imagine how heavy this is for some people. And this is truly one of my favorite things to talk about: learning to love my dad again. So I grew up and I was never fond of my dad. My dad put me through a lot of torture. And this is specifically with how he used to administer his discipline. So my dad was the disciplinarian and my mom was the kind, the cool, the gentle one, the one that you will always run to when your dad beats you. So the kind of beatings my dad used to administer were very intense. He will beat you, and trust me, you will sleep for a whole week nursing the same wounds that he caused you. So I never used to understand why he will do that, and I never used to love him for that. I hated him. Yes, I did hate my dad, to the point that I asked Allah to take my dad away. You can imagine how and where I was coming from, subhanAllah. And of course, part of it was because I was a child and I never used to understand why that will happen to me. Why is it that someone who loves you will do that to you? But subhanAllah, my mom was very resilient. My mom was always affirming us. My mom was always supporting us. And I never used to understand why she will not talk negatively about my dad, and given whatever he has put us through. So I remember every single thing. You do something small, he will always beat you. And I grew up with brothers. So most of the time, you can imagine, when we're in a small fight with my brothers, I'll always be the one to suffer because my brothers will always run out of my dad's hands. So subhanAllah, I was left, you know, receiving all the beatings of, you know, my brother's beating. So I did not understand why I was the one to always suffer. And I really considered myself as a kid who was suffered in her dad's hand. I did not have that connection with my dad. So I remember when I finished high school, I was around 17 years old. And I saw the spark in my dad's eyes when he received my KCSE results. And he called me and told me, "Abu, I have something for you." And boom, it was my results. He was the first one to view my results. So I saw the spark in his eyes, a spark that showed, you know, a fulfilling, you know, feeling that, you know what, she did not disappoint me, because he's a typical Kushite dad who never believed that girls will make him proud. But this particular day, my dad looked very proud. And I was like, "Huh, why would you look at me like that with such a spark, and you were never a part of my journey?" And when I mean he was never a part of my journey, I meant he was never there for me emotionally and whatnot. He will provide, he will pay for my school fees, but he was never there for me. So I grew up knowing that my mom is my dad and my mother. And imagine, we lived with my dad in the same house. So subhanAllah, that particular day, you know, aroused a lot of, you know, thoughts. And I remember going back to my mom and telling mom, "There's something that I've seen in my dad today and I don't understand what it is." And my mom told me simply, "Your dad always loves you and has always loved you." So little did I know, later in life, that is when I came to understand what my dad had gone through. And I remember, wallahi, one day I was in class 8 and my mom was in the kitchen. I went to the kitchen and asked my mom, "Mom, is my dad the real, my biological dad?" And my mom looked at me with these surprising eyes and she was like, "Mom, let me tell you one thing. I've never known any other man apart from your dad." So you can imagine what that statement, coming from a girl who is very young to her mom, you can imagine what that meant. So, subhanAllah, from that day, of course, my doubts were cleared, because the pain that he put me through. And Abu, I know you're watching this, and I really love you, and alhamdulillah, I've come to understand where you were coming from. Those words and whatever that I saw in my mom's eyes made me go back and relook at the whole perspective and refresh my relationship with my dad. Of course, at class 8, I wasn't very mature per se, so I couldn't make some decisions. I joined uni, and my mom was the one who brought me to that. During the admission day, she was the one who was there. SubhanAllah. So I remember my mom's words. And I was a very jovial person. I was extroverted. I was always the kind of person who will always make people happy. I'll always be there for people. But at night, I'll always go back to my room and cry. And cry, and people will never know that I cry at night. I felt a certain void in my heart, a void that could only be filled by my dad, because I needed a male figure. And as much as I had my brothers in my life, I needed that male figure, the one that I could share my struggle from teenage, you know, transiting from teenagehood to adulthood. And of course, uni life was challenging. You meet different people. And I wanted someone to talk to. I wanted someone, in as much as I had my mom, there are talks that I wanted to have with my dad. And I remember one particular morning, I woke up and I said, I need to change things. Things have to be different. And so again, my best places to find my place are always in the masjid. So I was in the masjid, and then I met a sister. Shout out to Dr. Munira. So, and another sister. So they were having a conversation, and I remember that day, that was my first time to meet my friend. So she spoke about her challenges as a child too, and whatever she has gone through. And we had similar experiences. But for her, she had taken a step ahead of me. She was a counseling psychology student. And so after our talk, subhanAllah, I remember pushing her to the bus stop, and we ended up speaking for hours. We didn't even want to separate because, you know, I mean, we were sharing the same common struggles. So I remember she managed to convince me, and I joined her class. And subhanAllah, one of our classes was the stages that is actually the first lesson that we undertook. The stages, the psychosocial and the psychological stages during childhood and whatnot. And subhanAllah, the first year to the 12th year was very interesting for me because I found a lot of gap in the stages and the stages that I didn't go through very well. And of course, as a child, a female child, the father figure is a very important person, and especially during the 1 to 6 years. So, wallahi, subhanAllah, that was a very eye-opening experience for me. And I remember sharing the same with my friend. And subhanAllah, that was the beginning of my forgiveness, well, you know, with my dad. And of course, part of it is healing myself, going through the healing processes. And part of, you know, my healing has really been fueled by my therapist, who has really helped me in this journey. So one day I woke up and I wrote a letter to my dad. And I remember reading this in my counseling room and I cried. I could not finish the letter. I tell you, I could not. Because I imagined my child writing this to me. And this was the letter that I was writing to my dad. It was one heartbreaking letter. And one day I said, I'm going to read this out loud to my dad. So I cried, and I remember that day, the session was just very emotional for me. And that was the beginning of my healing. So I went back, and I remember one of the holidays, I was off from work and I traveled home. And I went and I sat with my mom, and I asked my mom, Mom, you know what today? I want to know more about you and my dad. So my mom took me through a journey, you know, a journey of how my dad's life was from when he was a young boy, you know, because they grew up almost in the same place. So my mom knew my dad very well. So, subhanAllah, I realized my dad was a child that was never raised with both his parents. So you can imagine what that cost, you know, to him as a person. And so I realized one thing for sure is my dad was also going through a heart, you know, a heartbreaking experience. He was going through a lot as a person. And being raised alone, away from your siblings, wasn't also easy for him. So wallahi, for once, I was in the sitting room and I remember looking at my parents' bedroom, and of course my dad was inside, and I wanted to go and hug my dad, but I couldn't because I didn't have the guts. I didn't have the connection. So I said deeply, Ya Rab, may you make it easy for me one day to have a connection with my dad. So my mom, of course, is a very open-minded person. Both my parents are, actually. And she knew where I was coming from, and she knew why I was asking those questions, those hard questions. So I remember coming back and, you know, sharing the same experience with my therapist. And one thing that I decided was making my dad a part and parcel of my journey. Of course, for us, the education that we have is not the education that our parents had. So the insights that I had, probably my dad did not have. You know, SubhanAllah, we have forums, we have all these materials online that we can read about, you know, going through that journey of healing, going through that journey of forgiveness and whatnot. So we are empowered compared to our parents. So I remember I came up with resolutions, and I wrote in my diary, because I used to call my mom more than my dad. So I said, if I'm calling my dad, my mom today, I'll call the next call is actually going to my mom. And I actually said, because the dad is the head of the family, I'll start with my dad. Of course, I couldn't expect our phone calls to be 2 hours long like mine and my mom's. But I said, let me start from somewhere. Even if it's the 2 minutes call to the 5 minutes call, slowly by slowly. I was taking the journey. And because I wanted to heal, I had to forgive my dad. And I had to take the step. So, yeah, that happened. And I remember in one of our phone calls, I've never told my dad this. I told my dad, Abu, I love you and I'm so grateful for your life. And for a moment, I could hear the silence in my dad's voice. SubhanAllah. I went into sujood and I thanked Allah because I could not imagine myself getting to that point in my life whereby I'll utter these beautiful words to my dad and tell him that I love you. So today and to date, my dad is my biggest buddy. And one thing that really helped me was coming up with a list. And SubhanAllah, the positives overweighed the negatives. I remember the first person who taught me how to cook ugali was my dad. The second person who taught me how to cook meat was my dad. The third person who taught me how to cook githeri was my dad. The fourth person who taught me how to pray, how to read Quran was my dad. So my dad has been this amazing man, and I haven't been able to see that. So just separating the human weaknesses from the person is very important when it comes to the glasses in which you look at your parents. And I know most probably haven't gone through the struggles that most of us have gone through or whatever. Mine can be way lighter than yours, or depending with the family setups that we have come from. So I'm not saying that whatever you've gone through with your dad is or your mom is not something heavy, but I say it's okay to actually feel those emotions. But remember that they are our parents. They have gone through a lot because of us. Even the fact that they beat us. I remember my dad telling me, I wanted to chop off the horns. So I'm like, but I don't have horns. I'm not a gazelle or something. So them disciplining us means that they want something better for us. As I'm talking to our parents also, when we are administering our discipline, please let's ensure that we do not hurt our kids in the process, because some of us might not have the ability to go through therapy or the finances to go through therapy, or they're not able to even come out of that particular hurt. And most of us might go into, you know, real depression. SubhanAllah, I'm just asking you and challenging you to go and do the same to your parents. go and research more on your parents, go and find more, you know, how was their childhood like? What is it that your dad does to you that is very good, despite the negatives that he brings, you know, on the table or to your life? And subhanAllah, I know it's not easy to sometimes forgive people, but forgiveness really frees us. It makes us look at life from a very different perspective and look at people from a different perspective and understand that humans have a weakness and no one can be perfect. So separating the bad things from the person is very important. Inshallah, I hope that these 10 days will bring a lot of healing in our lives. We will be able to look at our parents as people who have brought us to this dunya. They have struggled for us. They have gone through a lot of hardships just to make us who we are today, of course, by the mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, inshallah, I wish you all the best in your recreation of relationship with your moms and dads and your guardians and those who have actually raised you in one way or another.